Prolapse is a super common condition that people can actually address without having to go to surgery. Here are my top three tips that I give to patients that can help them avoid surgery, but also avoid the unwanted side effects of prolapse. Hi, my name is Laura Meihoffer, and on this channel, I help you gain optimal health through knowledge and movement. My first tip is to exhale with effort. Here's the deal. Our abdominal canister is a closed space. We have our diaphragm on top, our pelvic floor on the bottom, then we have our back muscles and tummy muscles creating the side walls. When we hold our breath, such as with lifting our kiddos, picking up the laundry, maybe rowing in CrossFit or Orange Theory, that causes increased pressure in our abdominal canister. And that pressure makes our pelvic organs move down and into the vaginal canal. So if you already have prolapse, it's going to worsen those symptoms because your organs are going to move to the areas of least resistance. If you don't have prolapse, it's going to stretch and lengthen connective tissues that hold your organs up in place because we simply are not supposed to hold our breath with effort. What you can do moving forward is to always exhale with effort. This will help to minimize any increased pressure in that abdominal canister and will also help you to engage and activate the whole core canister appropriately to give those pelvic organs the proper stability they need to stay inside your body. Okay, I promise I won't interrupt your regularly scheduled program for too long, but I wanted to announce a solution I have for you. One of the side effects of prolapse is urinary incontinence, and it is so pesky. But here's the thing. On those times when you are racing to the bathroom and you don't think you're gonna make it in time, you feel that dribble as you're pulling your pants down and you just feel like I have no sense of control. Well, don't fret. I have just the solution for you. Check out the description box below where I have outlined an amazing program with 4 simple steps to help you gain control over your urinary incontinence today. Go check it out and let's get back to it. My second tip is resting with your hips above your heart. Here's the deal. The pelvic floor has many jobs that it has to do in a day, just like you. It's extremely busy, but we rarely rest, let alone even take time to sit down. Taking a moment to purposefully elevate our hips above our heart, just like in the photo I've included right here, helps you to allow those organs to move back and inside of your body. And it allows your pelvic floor muscles to have full range of motion and rest, which is what's needed to have optimal strength. Take a load off either when you're having symptoms such as heaviness, dullness, aching, tension, or just at the end of the night to rest with your hips above your heart for 5 to 10 minutes, doing some nice, slow, gentle breathing. This is going to greatly help with any pelvic organ prolapse that you're currently dealing with, or it will help to decrease the risk of developing it later in life. My third tip is pelvic floor muscle strengthening, or as people commonly refer to it, Kegels. But here's the deal. You can't just do any old type of pelvic floor strengthening. You need to do it correctly. And 50 to 80% of you will complete it incorrectly if you just do it through verbal explanation alone. If you have a PT close by, go to them. But if you can't afford it or aren't interested in going into a PT, that's okay, because I have this amazing Luna Smart Bead. What I love about this amazing device is that it remembers your performance and it completely takes the guesswork out of how to write your own program. It has 5 different set programs, and based on your performance, it will make it harder or easier. But here's the deal. Consistency is key. So make sure that when you are using the Luna Smart Bead, that you go ahead and use it for 3 to 4 days per week, 6 to 8 weeks, because that is how long it takes to notice strength gains. So if you want to learn more about this device, check out the video I linked in the screen and I'll meet you over there. Otherwise, continue with the 3 tips I outlined today for how you can change your life with Prolapse today.